All right, it's a new day. We got more to do. We're ready. I'm pretty sure, I know I did a little bit in between, but I'm pretty sure the last time we did this, I was at the point of putting this on. So I need to first go through and put the injector wires on, put the spark plug wires on, and the knock sensor, and I need to put the thermostat, I think it's not the thermostat, it's the temperature sensor housing. That's what I was looking for. So what I am gonna do is get some light. Something I did in the meantime was I took off the mount for the motor mount so I could get in there and do the timing when the time comes. So you missed out on that. I'll show you how it goes back together. So first thing I'm gonna do, and this connector is broken, so they put a little bit of glue on it. I'll probably do the same. So first thing I'm gonna do is run these wires where we're supposed to go. This goes here. This one down the bottom, you won't be able to see it. It's an aux sensor. You just gotta get it lined up. I had this unscrewed. I tightened that back up. I think I showed you that in the last video. The spark plugs are in. Alright. This is a temperature sensor. Not sure what this one is. We'll figure it out. They're all pretty unique. So let's do the... Let's do spark plug wires first, and then we'll do the... You'll feel it. It feels different. Oh, I'm trying to think. This probably went behind here. In front of it. Let's see what it looks like if it's in front of it. I have a feeling that went behind this. I don't remember. It's hard to get in there, so I guess it is on top. There is a little bit of room in here when you have the top of the engine on. You can do the spark plugs without taking the intake off. I've done it before. I have two others of these Jettas. So we're going to call that good. It's just I haven't done spark plugs in forever, so I don't remember where these go. So we're assuming they go here. It's wrong. We will fix it afterwards. And it's not that big of a deal. This is so much easier to do with a good pair of needle nose. Once you get it lined up, that is. Yep, that feels good. so I'll just tuck these out of the way for now. I don't remember if this is right, but that's where it's staying for now. I'm just going to tuck that out of the way. Okay, so temperature sensor. I put a new gasket on here. I don't remember if I showed you that. There's a new gasket on there. You gotta replace this one too. I gotta go find the correct one. Alright, so our new O-ring is in there. Probably should get a little bit of this crud off of here. And then, you gotta figure out which way this goes. I believe it's this way. Yeah, it's this way. And then one of these has a stud on it. Here you attach that mount that's right there. The other one also has a stud, but it doesn't, I don't think anything attaches to that. It should be good. Like I said, don't go crazy. Just make sure this didn't loosen up at all. Good. Alright, so that should be alright. Now, I do believe this guy goes here. This holds something. I think it's one of these, but we're not there yet. And then this one, which I have out of the way here, goes here. Which I'm missing the clamp for that. So that must be the one I can sit right here. Must be this one. So off this one goes. Now, right in this area, I forget to put a hose on towards the bottom, and if it recorded it, I'll show you later. I end up spilling some coolant when I fill it up. But there is a hose down here that I missed, and you can't really see it, but just be aware I missed one here. Look around, there's another hose that gets plugged in. So that looks good. Now the only thing I'm missing is this is a temperature sensor. Unless there's issues, I'm not putting anything on there. It feels pretty good. And this, I need to figure out where it goes. I may have to look back at my video to figure out where this one goes to. This just pushes on to something. But we're missing a lot here still, so. Alright, so next I am going to do the oxygen sensor and the cover that goes here. Which I probably should have done before this, because there's a stupid pipe on the back that gets in the way. And then string it through. So, I don't know if I'll be able to show you down under the car, but the oxygen sensor basically just goes straight down and around the steering column. And there's a little black box underneath. It's hard to miss. And yeah, I don't know why I just put that down there, because this has to go through the guard first. But the oxygen sensor, it just plugs in down at the bottom. So what we do first is we just go like this, through. Try not to get it stuck. Try not to mess with the wire too much. this back on down there. Place where it goes. Otherwise, it may get burned. So that's going to be for a little while from now. So now, the easy part. The easy part is putting this part back on. The hard part is putting the tube that goes from here down there back on. And that's just because I don't have the right tool to do that job, so. One there, one there, one here. These are longer bolts than everything else. They're the same size as the intake, the bottom intake bolt. And there's one that's small. This guy's tiny. He goes over here. He goes up over here. So just be aware, one of them is a different size here. Little, and I don't want it to get messed up. And I really need this light to do something else because it's blinding me. Sure, there's a torque spec for these. I'm just hand tightening because I don't see any reason not to. I'm just gonna check the other ones are tight enough, which they should be. I'm not going to hook these hoses up yet because I got to get this pipe on. I'm hoping this isn't too much in the way. If it is, I'll just pop it back off for the time being. Look at how clogged up that is. I'll have to clean that out first. Okay. Let's just hook it up and tighten it down a little bit. Bottom is the longer side. Not a whole lot of room to work down here. like I said, this isn't the correct wrench for this, but it's close. So, I don't remember how I got her off on the top, but I'm sure it's in the video. Bottom one is like a freaking nightmare to get to. Hell of a lot easier to get to that one from the bottom, so that's what you should do. So next, am I forgetting anything over here? Alright, so there's not much oil in here, but nothing. So you definitely have to put oil over the top of your valves before you close all this up. So what I'm gonna do, dump a bunch of oil in here. Because there's gonna be some time when the car starts and there's going to be no oil, so I'm going to dump this on there, and this thing's going to get an oil change right after it's been run for a little while. So then we're going to put this guy on, but it's definitely going to need an oil change. So the gasket, where I heard it or read it or what, but I remember always hearing that you should put some RTV in the corners here. This is just what came with the gasket maker, the gasket itself. So I'm just gonna do that. I'm not gonna go crazy. Seriously, worst tube of crap ever. Like I said, I don't think it needs it, but whatever. So, now we're going to find out. So, this looks good. we're doing the intake. The upper intake. The bolts that go in here are only supposed to be 10 newton meters, which is like 7.4. Pounds. Let me see if I can get two of these in here. Just to line this up. Gonna go crazy tight yet. I'm also gonna put my two best looking ones in the back. Just so if they get stripped in the future, you know, it'll be a front one, which will be easier to get to in comparison to a back one, which will be impossible to get to. Those are where they're supposed to be. Probably shouldn't shake the engine because it's on an engine stand. Alright, so let's start hooking up some of these hoses. This one. This one. This one. So this one must go here. I have this feeling I'm going to have to pull this one off again when I fill it up. Just to bleed out some of the air. This one goes here. I think Pushes on there. Got this little thing to keep it from rubbing against that. So this sensor goes here. Alright, so now I gotta do the air pump, which only has one bolt left on it. I should probably replace these other ones, but for now, I'm just gonna put it back on the way it is. I can zip tie it in place. I gotta find the plug that goes to this. We're gonna put that on. So now I can do, I think, the air box, and then the last tube, which is part of this. This on here. I don't know why this had this on here, but double high. So that one, and we got this one, which goes from the air box. The air pump. It'll give you a good click when you go into place. This one looks a little broken. Attached, didn't click, but I had one of these crack on one of my other ones and it ended up causing all kinds of other problems. So something to be aware of. Alright, here's the other one. This tube is marked where it's supposed to get clamped to. I just had these bolts in there in the beginning to stop the flow of everything every which direction. So, keep that a little bit now. Oh, I forgot. I got one more bolt that has to go into the back of the intake. Good thing I looked. Hopefully I can reach it. Yeah, that's it. Alright. something on... Oh, this is the coolant reservoir. This... Is this this? The positioning looks like this one goes here. And this one goes back here. So I'll give you a little once over on the top of the engine so you can see where everything goes, because just doing this alone, I'm not going to record everything as I go. So. May need to take a couple of these things back out of the way for the motor mount, but we'll see. I'm not really too worried about it. Alright. So now I need to time this engine. Like everything else is done. Pull this out of the way for the time being. So let's give a quick once over of everything. So tubes. This goes here, this goes here, this goes all the way back to the thing that has that really hard metal pipe that goes around. This guy goes back onto here, this guy goes here, I gotta put this clamp on. Like I said, it's always good to go over this stuff. This clamp's gotta go on. All your coolant hoses, I can see one that's supposed to be in a clamp. That's the only thing I see missing down here. And this guy goes here. This guy goes onto there. And this pipe goes here. Trip myself. And over here, make sure these are attached. These two hoses don't look very good, so probably should be replaced. This one goes here, comes from there. This one goes down to here. I think these two are right. That's the position they kind of fell into. You got extra sensors. So now I gotta time it. I just have the timing belt sitting on there. I'm pretty sure the tensioner is in the wrong way, so I gotta figure that out. So yeah, I'm just gonna go over the last few things here, make sure they're right, put on those clamps, and then I'm gonna start timing the car. All right, the timing marks are all correct. I just ran it over like four times with my hand, if not more. Comes up fine. Looks like it's a hair off just because it is a hair off down there. It just needs to come up a hair, but it's correct. I went through it twice, or four times, like I said. Oh, it was fun turning the engine over four times when it has compression. So now I'm going to try to start it. Should be fun. There's like no gas at the moment throughout, so it's going to probably kick over a bit before it starts. Cross your fingers, everything's okay. The tensioner is correct. Popped right into position. Tightened it to 15 foot-pounds, like it said, which is 20 newton meters. So, like I said, cross your fingers. I think everything else is good. Probably need to put some oil in it. And maybe I'll throw some coolant in to get that starting to move. And plug in the coolant sensor too. The only thing that's disconnected right now is the power steering, because there's no fluid in it anyway, from what I can tell, and it's not running the power steering pump because I don't have all that serpentine belt and everything put back on. So. Thank you. hose. Which hose did we forget? So, sorry I didn't get to record the timing for this car. It's really pretty simple, but here's the car running. You'll hear it's making a lot of noise when you first start it out. It sounds like death. What this is it's a new head. It has no oil in the lifters, and they're hydraulic lifters, so it takes a little while for the oil to come up into the lifters and get the engine quiet again. I believe there's a break-in procedure. I can't remember it off the top of my head, but I think you have to rev it up to a certain RPM and hold it there for a little while, and then you won't hear the noise anymore. The hydraulic lifters will get filled up, and they'll be good to go. So the car gets silent after I did the break-in. I can't remember, like I said, what it was, but once you do that, you're good to go. And that's it for the head replacement. Should be more stuff coming. Likely, it's going to be go-kart related next, or small engine related. I'm kind of in the mood for that stuff. Maybe 3D printing. I don't know. I can do that too. All right, see you then.